back. Now, after the recovery of huge amount of foreign currency, about 8.5 crore rupees by the Himachal police from the accountant of the Karmapa, head of the second Buddhist sect across the Tibetan Himalayas, the Indian security agencies will question the Karmapa for his alleged Chinese links. Now, Indian intelligence suspect that his plan was to create a network of China-friendly Tibetan institutions across the Himalayas. Now, the main aim, according to early reports, was to take over the influential Rumtek Monastery, which has over 700 overseas branches. And in what could be a big setback for the Gujarat Chief Minister Narendra Modi, a senior Gujarat police officer has said that there is evidence that shows that Ishrat Jahan encounter was in fact staged. Now, Ahmedabad's Joint Commissioner of Police Satish Verma, who is an officer in the special investigation team probing the case, has filed an affidavit in the High Court saying that a separate FIR should be filed against the police officers involved in this encounter. Now, Ishrat Jahan was killed in an alleged fake encounter in June 2004. Gujarat police at the time of encounter had claimed that Ishrat Jahan and three others were in fact LET operatives on a mission to kill the Chief Minister Narendra Modi. And even as the Chief Vigilance Commissioner PJ Thomas has become a major embarrassment for the government, sources have told NDTV that the controversial CVC has refused to quit. Now, Thomas stayed in his office the whole day and refused to comment on his controversy surrounding him. Now, according to the sources, government is now looking at other options and is hoping that the court declares his appointment illegal. Meanwhile, the government is putting up a brave face. Sources are telling us that the government is getting ready to face the BJP in the court. Now, leader of the opposition, Sushma Swaraj, had yesterday said that the PM's panel did discuss the case against Thomas. She said that she will file an affidavit in the Supreme Court. Well, NDTV has accessed the crucial papers connected to the appointment of PJ Thomas as the Chief Vigilance Commissioner, an issue which has become a huge embarrassment for the government today. Now, the papers were disclosed in response to an RTI application by Subhash Chandra Agarwal. The documents record leader of opposition Sushma Swaraj's dissent. And while there are no details of why she opposed Thomas's candidature, it is clear that the issue was discussed by the high part panel, that is the Prime Minister, Home Minister and Swaraj herself. Now, yesterday, the Attorney General had told the Supreme Court that details of Thomas's case had been brought to the notice of the panel, but he was forced to clarify after a political storm. Well, meanwhile, senior BJP leader LK Advani says it is shocking that the government claims that the Prime Minister and the Home Minister were not aware of the case against Thomas, as Sushma Swaraj had quite clearly taken up the details.
विपक्ष का नेता था तब से लेकर के ये विवाद शुरू हुआ कि मैंने उन्हें कहा एक जहाँ जहाँ पर भी अब कानून बने हैं कि विपक्ष का नेता होना चाहिए लोकसभा का सरकार के साथ साथ जो निर्णय करे तो उसमें शुरू में वो एक नाम देते थे तो मैंने उन्हें कहा कि मैं नहीं मानूंगा जब तक आप पैनल नहीं देंगे सुषमा जी ने भी यही कहा कि मैं इनका नाम नहीं मानूंगी क्योंकि इनके खिलाफ एक केस चल रहा है सीबीआई जांच कर रही है और ये सबसे बड़ा अधिकारी है सेंट्रल विजिलेंस कमिश्नर है उनके ऊपर कोई केस चल रहा है तो उसको हम कैसे रख सकते हैं मैं जो दूसरे दो नाम आपने बताए हैं मैं उनको जानती नहीं लेकिन उन दो में से किसी को भी मान लो मुझे कोई आपत्ति नहीं
Well, the BJP seems to be collecting political brownie points. And here's another one that should make them feel more comfortable. Attacks on churches in Karnataka shocked the country in 2008. Now, more than 2 years on, the Justice B.K. Somashekhar Commission of Inquiry has submitted its report to the government. Now, Justice Somashekhar Commission has given a clean chit to the BJP government and the state police in the 2008 church attacks. Now, on to the bail plea of the nine Muslims accused in the Maligarh blast case. The CBI has opposed the bail plea, saying that the defense has not given valid reasons for the bail. Now, CBI has filed its reply in the 2006 Maligarh blast case in the Bombay High Court. The CBI has also sought permission to reinvestigate the case based upon Asima Anand's confession. Now, the accused, who has been in jail for 4 years now, filed a bail petition after Swami Asima Anand's confession that Hindu activists carried out the blasts. Well, as the debate over Hindu terror grows, there's been an increasing scrutiny of organizations such as the RSS and its alleged involvement in recent terror attacks. Now, today, a group of civil society organizations in Delhi held a seminar to discuss questions of identity and religion. Now, the group demanded that all terror attacks over the last 2 decades be reinvestigated. Now, amongst the notable speakers were Congress Party's Digvijay Singh, who traced back divisive communal tensions back to L.K. Advani's Rath Yatra in 1992. Now, meanwhile, the CPM's Sitaram Yechuri was more nuanced, saying that terror cannot be associated with any religion.
जब जब भारतीय जनता पार्टी कमजोर होती है, वे कोई न कोई सांप्रदायिक मुद्दा लाते हैं। मंदिर वहीं बनाएंगे जहां झगड़ा हो, तिरंगा वहीं फैलाएंगे जहां झगड़ा हो, घर पर तिरंगा नहीं फहराएंगे, आरएसएस के हेडक्वार्टर पे तिरंगा नहीं फहराएंगे, वहां भगवा फहराएंगे, हुबली के ईदगाह पे तिरंगा फहराएंगे, जहां झगड़ा होगा वहां हम जाएंगे, क्योंकि बिना झगड़े के हमारी दाल रोटी चलनी नहीं है। बात यही है, इसका हमें सभी को विरोध करना चाहिए और इस पर लड़ाई लड़ना चाहिए।
Well, moving ahead, and what came as a relief for consumers around the city, onion prices have finally come down. Now, remember, the Pongal weekend had seen the onion prices climb to alarming levels of nearly 80 rupees per kilo. Well, here's our reporter Lokpriya telling us again what you can expect in the grocery shopping.
The sunny weather has indeed brought some good news to the residents of the city. The prices of onions that literally made us cry till about a fortnight ago has now dropped. The prices of onion is 24 rupees per kilo at the retail outlets. Yes, you heard it right, 24 rupees per kilo. This is the price at the retail outlet. The prices at the Coimbatore wholesale market is much lesser by about 4 rupees. It's about 20 rupees per kilo. Traders at the market say the reason for the reduction in the prices is because after the Pongal season, the sun has been shining very strongly and the fields have begun to dry up. And also the second crop that is coming in from Maharashtra have come in plenty. So there are enough stock to last till about April. And they also say that the prices have stabilized and the prices will remain the same till about April, May. And they also say that the price of other vegetables also have come down, especially tomato, carrot, beans. Even they have come down, bringing much needed respite to the common man in the wake of increasing prices of the essential commodities. So the next time you want to feast on those yummy onion pakodas, you need not think twice. In Chennai, Lokpriya, NDTV Hindu.
Well, let's in fact take a look at how the vegetable prices were doing today. Beginning with the ladyfingers, again a little over 50 rupees a kilo. Beans was priced at rupees 30. Brinjal was doing at 15 rupees a kilo and was the cheapest vegetable in the market. Onion and potatoes were doing just a little above 20 rupees a kilo mark. Well, speaking of vegetables, it's time to shed the excess. That's what you can expect with this chef serving tingling delights, but it does keep your waistline in check. We bring you the gourmet delights on the other side.